I have to start off by telling you a little bit about HTC. So HTC is a multinational mobile device manufacturer that's in Taiwan. We have been building phone for over 20 years, and since 2007, we have shipped over 100 million phones, all made in Taiwan with our talented engineers. And we've proven ourselves that we could build trusted hardware. We built the first Android device. We built the first 4G Android smartphone in the U.S., and we have the first one with, you know, the dual camera and all that. On our journey to the pursuit of brilliance, we have always been adapting the latest tech to find out ways to improve our lives. And we see the beauty of blockchain, and we believe that the mobile device is the agent of decentralization. So Phil, our decentralized chief officer, announced the Exodus project back in May at Consensus. And we have many, many things we're planning to do, with the goal to build a foundation of trust and security for the blockchain ecosystem on mobile devices. The early access of Exodus 1 was announced last week, and we're only accepting Bitcoin and Ethereum. The purpose of this early access is to, first of all, show people that we're really doing this, and the most important thing is to really invite more people to work with us. The first step for us is to build a secure environment to protect our users' crypto assets, because cryptocurrencies is the first step to have anyone go into blockchain. So we think it's really important that we build a secure environment for people to be able to explore what blockchain can do. And it is our belief that we should let our data go and have ownership of our assets, data, and even identity. But also, what we usually forget is to keep an eye on, you know, the methods we're protecting our properties. So we found that the truth is most users don't understand and many times forget about the security, and it is our responsibility as a manufacturer and developers to keep an eye out for them, for the security. So we have created Zion, the all-in-one secure access to blockchain. Starting with the Zion wallet, we're utilizing what we already have in the phone, a TEE, Trusted Execution Environment, by ARM, called TrustZone, to safeguard the keys. So TEE runs in parallel of the operating system in an isolated environment. Trusted applications running in a TEE have access to the main processor and memory, whereas the hardware isolation protects these components from user-installed applications running in the main operating system. So software and cryptographic isolations inside the TEE protects the different contained trusted applications from each other as well. And on top of the TEE, our trusted UI, when users are typing in passcodes, authorizing payments, and reading their seeds, it will be all done under a trusted UI where not even Android can touch. So this is how we're, you know, providing this initial security for the users. And our second feature this year is the social key recovery. This feature is optional on top of the 12-word Z recovery phrase. Basically, you can set up 5 trusted contacts of your choice, iPhone or Android, and Zion will break your seed and encrypt using Shamir secret sharing. When in need, your trusted contact can help you recover the wallet. And I'm going to give you an example of the use case. So, say Mr. Trump bought the Exodus 1, and he created the Zion wallet and did what he was told, secure his seed phrase and his vote at the White House. And he traveled around the world to promote world peace, as he usually do. And on the way to North Korea, his Exodus 1 dropped and fell off the Air Force 1. And with his seed phrase locked in the White House, he cannot access his wallet and can't pay for gas for the Air Force 1. So luckily, Mr. Trump set up the social key recovery with Zion. So he called his trusted contact, putting President Xi and Merkel at the gas station. He was able to have all 3 of his trusted contacts recover his wallet for him. So that's the idea of one way to use social key recovery. Last but not least, our Zion Key Management API will soon be available. We would like to work with anyone who believes the same, let my data go, and build a foundation of trust and security. So Zion API will allow your dApp to store your key in the TEE to provide an added value for your users on Exodus. Also, your users will be able to be protected by the trusted UI when authorizing transactions and more. So we're inviting, you know, if you have a dApp or a wallet or a marketplace or, you know, anything you're working on that could be using this for an added value, feel free to contact me if you are interested. So we're also open to work with projects that believes in people owning their own data. One of our goals down the pipeline is to achieve like what our tagline says, let my data go. If you're working on a project that's related to distributed resources and allowing people to decide or share or donate their components on the phone or their data, we're really interested in knowing more about your project as well. Like Phil always says, this was a promise of the internet, and which why someone like me and many of us and many of the people in the room to get into that go into the industry in the first place. The promise of open network, freely share of knowledge, and unleashing human creativity. And today I'm not here to sell more phones, although as much as I like every one of you, just you know, purchase one right now. But I'm here to ask for your help, to help make our vision come true, one phone at a time. It's not something we could be doing on our own, and we shouldn't be doing on our own as well. So please join us to build a foundation of trust and security. Or if you just want to share what you're doing, we're always happy to host you. So please feel free to contact me if you're interested in any of the above, and would like to know about what we're doing or how we could collaborate. And thank you very much for your time today.